सॉफ्टवेयर टेस्टिंग, टेस्टिंग कंप्यूटर सॉफ्टवेयर और वेदर इट इज वर्किंग आर नॉट एज पर रिक्वायरमेंट्स. सी व्हाट आर द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स फॉर सॉफ्टवेयर टेस्टिंग. सी फर्स्ट वी हैव टू लर्न SDLC models. Actually, it is development concern, but software testing also part of software development. So, testers also need to learn SDLC process. Software development life cycle. Software testing life cycle also part of SDLC. See, what is SDLC? Software development life cycle, a systematic approach to develop software applications. A systematic approach to develop software application. See, in the industry we have so many models. We can segregate them in two categories. First category, sequential models. Next, incremental or iterative models. Sequential models means stage by stage development happens. After completion of each stage, next stage will begin. One stage output is input for next stage. Next, incremental or iterative model. See, incremental. See, first we divide development, software development into increments. We add requirements step by step. See, incremental models or iterative models. See, examples for sequential models: waterfall model, V model, etc. Example for incremental or iterative models: agile model, next spiral model, etc. Incremental models are expensive, but success rate is very high. Okay, see, SDLC is not our direct topic, but our testing is part of SDLC, so we must aware of SDLC. Next, our direct subject, test levels. See, in software development and testing we have four levels of testing. Testers may vary from one level to another, but testing four levels. First one, unit testing or component testing or program testing or module testing. All these are synonyms. Unit testing or component testing or program testing or module testing. Developers conduct this type of testing using white box test design techniques. Testing an individual component is called unit testing. Next, integration testing. This type of testing also generally developers conduct, integration testing. Next, system testing. Generally independent testers, separate testing teams, independent testers perform this type of testing using black box test design techniques. Black box, no need to aware of the code. White box means structural testing. System testing, generally we use black box test design techniques. Black box testing or specification based testing. Okay. Next, last one, acceptance testing. Customers or customer side people, end users, conduct this type of testing by accepting software. Customer or customer side people perform this type of testing. Okay. See, next, already we discussed testers may vary from one level to another. Suppose if it is unit testing or integration testing, testers are developers. System testing, testers are independent testers. Acceptance testing, testers are end users or customer side people. Next, after learning test levels, here our main focus area is system testing. Forget about unit testing and integration testing and acceptance testing. Our independent testers' main focus area is system testing. Next, test types. Test types. See, basically we have two categories of testing, two types of testing. Functional testing, non-functional testing. See, you take any application, any software application, functional testing is mandatory, non-functional optional. See, 80 to 80% market area functional testing, 15 to 20% market area non-functional testing. See, what is functional testing? Verifying a component or system's functionality with respect to functional requirements. What is non-functional testing? Verifying system's quality attributes with respect to non-functional requirements. Functional testing example, functionality testing, security testing, etc. Non-functional testing, so many subtypes, load, stress, endurance testing, all are subsets of performance testing. Next, usability testing, localization testing, internalization testing, recovery testing, reliability testing, configuration testing, etc. See, next one, test design techniques. Next learning objective, test design technique. Technique means an easy way to do something, an easy way to do something, an optimized way to do something. Here, test design technique. First of all, why test design technique? See, exhaustive testing is impractical. That's why we use test design techniques. What is exhaustive testing? Testing with all possible inputs and preconditions. Exhaustive testing is impractical. In order to reduce input domain, we use test design techniques. See, in the IT industry, we have three categories of test design techniques. White box or structured based techniques. Black box or specification based techniques. Next, experience based techniques. Generally, our focusing area is black box techniques. See, white box, developers use those techniques. Example, statement testing, condition testing, multi-condition testing, decision testing, etc. Black box testing, our area, independent testers conduct this type of techniques, use this type of techniques. Example, equivalent classes or equivalent partitions. Next, boundary value analysis, decision table testing, state transition testing, use case testing, etc. Next, experience based techniques are informal way. See, testing basically two types, formal process, informal process. If time is limited or no documentation or less or less budget, less or no infrastructure, that time we follow experienced based techniques. See, most of the time we use these techniques for some scenarios. suppose if we don't have proper documentation time, that time we prefer that way. Informal testing. Here important experience based techniques are error guessing, exploratory testing, etc. Next one, heart of the software testing, software test process, or you can say STLC, software testing life cycle. See, in standard process, see, test process may vary from one company to another and one project to another, but this is standard process. See, in standard process we have four phases of life cycle, four phases. First one, test planning. See, planning the testing activities. Generally test lead or team lead or test manager is responsible for test planning activities, but all team members contribution required. Next stage, test design. Here, after understanding the requirements, deriving test scenarios, test case documentation and test data collection. Next, third stage, important stage, test execution. Here, executing sanity tests. First, forming test batches, execution queue. Next, sanity testing means verifying whether the build is acceptable or not by executing some basic functionality tests, login like. Next, comprehensive testing. See, these are levels of test execution. First level, sanity testing. Next level, comprehensive testing. Comprehensive testing means executing all possible cases, maximum cases. Next, defect reporting and tracking. Next, re and regression testing on modified software builds. Next, at the end, final regression. Next, last stage or phase of software test process, test closure. Here, evaluating the exit criteria, collecting all artifacts from test activities. Next, preparing test summary report, means summarizing all test activities. Next, collecting all artifacts, sending test deliverables to customer. These are the important tasks in this last stage of or last phase of software test life cycle. See, next, software quality standards. See, what is the relation between quality and testing? Testing improves quality. If you perform better testing, if you conduct better testing, definitely we can increase the quality of software application. See, we have some non-government standard organizations are there. They are providing terminology, documentation standards and process standards. As a test engineer, you must aware of software standards. ISO, old organization, international organization for standards. International organization for standards, Europe based non-government organization. It provides standards for all types of industries, but our IT industry point of view, it is providing terminology, terms. Example, what is verification, what is regression testing, like terms. Next, documentation standards, how to prepare documents. Next, some process guidelines. Next, IEEE, Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers, US based organization. It provides test documentation standard from test planning to test closure. Next, terminology. Next, CMM, capability maturity model integration. It provides process for software development. Next, last topic, focusing areas. See, what are the major focusing areas for software tester? See, important task, initial task, understanding software requirements. Understanding software requirements. Next, deriving scenarios, test scenarios or outlines from requirements. Next, one more core area, test case documentation. What is test case? An input, preconditions, post conditions, expected result for verifying a test condition. Next, test data collection. See, for most of test cases, test data required. Tester need to collect the test data. Test execution, already we discussed. Here important areas are sanity testing, comprehensive testing, re and regression testing. Next, defect reporting and tracking. See, these are the learning objectives for software tester. Thank you.